Shanghai has a reputation. She's known as a playground for the rich. She's wealthy and also not afraid to flaunt it. Now, with the best bars, clubs, restaurants, and hotels, I'll tell you what, you'll be able to just savor the best of East and West flavors right here in International Shanghai. But the first thing that greets you is this impressive Pudong International Airport. How would we get to the city?
The Maglev.
What is the Maglev?
Fast train.
You can get a single trip that's valid for one day or round trip that's valid for 7 days. But if you've got your air ticket, keep it handy with you because you get a discount. Crazy! I just feel like I'm flying. This is the magnetic levitation, which is called the maglev, and it's incredible. You can feel the engine just kind of pumping up, and it just feels like we're in a plane and heading off for a takeoff. Can you see that we're kind of tilted on the side? Yeah. How do you feel about the train ride? Is it, you know?
It was a very good experience.
Yeah.
Going this very fast train because we come from Germany, and it's interesting that we have to go to China to go into the fast train.
It's amazing. Do you know that this is really German technology?
Yes, I know.
Do you have it in Germany?
We don't have it in Germany, and we are very sad about not having it.
يقولون إن بودونغ المستقبلية هي خطوط معمارية حديثة ونظيفة تؤكد أهمية شنغهاي باعتبارها العاصمة التجارية للصين. وعام 1980 كانت المناطق الريفية والأراضي الزراعية منتشرة في كل مكان فيها، ولكن عام 1990 بدأ التطور يعم هذه المنطقة وأصبحت منطقة منفتحة حديثا على التنمية الاقتصادية. بودونغ أخذت اسمها من موقعها الذي يشرف على الجانب الشرقي لنهر هوانغبو.
I've made a reservation under the name Greta Georges.
Okay, this will be the address. Go to our front desk.
All right.
Miss Georges, okay, this is it's very Le Bang View room for you, and you can see the very famous Le Bang River in Shanghai.
It's very iconic.
Yes, it's very nice. You know. And this is we offer the telescope for you, and you can through it and look at the beautiful Le Bang View.
Wow, that's very, very nifty. I can spy on my neighbors.
Yes. And this is your room number, and the key I keep on the door open later.
All right.
Okay, so please enjoy your stay.
Cheers, thank you very
much. Welcome, bye.
Bye.
فنادق البودينغ تقدم إلى زبائنها الكثير من سبل الراحة. مساحة المنطقة الاقتصادية 552 كيلومترا مربع، وتعد من أرقى الأماكن، وتستوعب أكثر عدد ممكن من الأشخاص القادمين من مختلف أنحاء العالم.
But looks like it's the start of a brand new foggy day, and I'm really excited to meet Steven. Now he knows all about the city, and he's going to show me around the Pudong. So, can't wait.
Hey, welcome to Shanghai.
Yeah. church. I really like it. The city is just, you know, quite amazing. The tall buildings and skyscrapers, really, really sleek.
Yeah, speaking of skyscrapers, two of our tallest are right here.
Wow.
Yeah, the Jinmao Tower and the Shanghai World Financial Trade Center.
Fantastic. Are we going to go?
We are going to go, and I'm going to show you the park first. Because even though it's in the middle of Pudong, you feel like you're out in the countryside.
You know what? This feels like the breathing space of the city. I just
can't. Really nice.
Air is really crisp here. I expected it to be kind of polluted.
Yeah, no, it's cleaner here. And here you can see kids playing with fish in the pond. I mean,
yeah.
It's really nice.
Cool.
It's really.
بوتونغ تعد موطنا للفرسان العمالقة ثلاثة، وتعد شنغهاي المركز المالي العالمي، ويعتبر برج جينماو وبرج التلفزيون بمثابة لؤلؤة الشرق. أنجز برج جينماو عام 1998، ويعد هذا البرج من أطول الأبراج في المدينة حتى عام 2007. من الطابق 53 وحتى الطابق 87 نجد فندق غراند حيات شنغهاي. هنا تم العثور على الجزء المشهور في الطابق 56 بسقفه الذي يصل إلى كل الاتجاهات، وبارتفاع يصل حتى الطابق 87 من المكان الذي نقف فيه. إنه عبارة عن هيكل مجزأ يستمد إلهامه من مفاصل الخيزران المرنة. وإذا كنت ترغب بمشاهدة عرض لعين الطائر فيمكنك أن تحلق فوق السماء في الطابق 88.
Okay, so if the Jinmao Tower is a metaphor for a pen and the Huangpu River the metaphor for ink, then Greta, check this out. This is where you can write something. These people have written their wishes and hung them on the prayer tree.
That's very clever of you, Steve. I remember you said that this tower is modeled after a pagoda,
yeah.
And you can find this near a temple as
exactly,
well.
Exactly, exactly.
Sense.
And it's not the only place you can write something. Look over here. I want to show you this. What do these look like? Of course.
Postcards.
Postcards. But
yeah.
Here you can write it, stamp it, mail it, all in one go.
Oh, that's really cool, because usually when you buy postcards, it just sits in your bag for like
forever.
Months.
Yeah.
Okay. How much is this?
And just 35 yuan.
35 yuan.
For 20 postcards, that's not
bad. Yeah, which is a new collection?
This one.
Okay, 4.5 stamps is for international.
الخطوة التالية مركز شنغهاي المالي العالمي.
The 95th story. It's a long way up.
Are you ready to see this?
Yeah.
This is awesome.
Wow, check it out. I can see right across and the skyline is beautiful.
Yeah.
It would come on a really nice day.
Now, coming right here to the center.
Right.
Now look down.
Oh my goodness. Are you kidding me?
We are standing
wow.
on glass.
That looks fantastic. Is this actually strong enough?
It's structurally sound. Three people can jump
Three.
On one square.
Three.
Yeah, and it's safe.
Shall we?
Yeah.
Okay. Anybody else wants to jump?
Come on.
Come and join us. When this bug around, you know it's
yeah,
really, 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 really safe. Awesome.
Yeah. Good job.
Bye bye.
Okay.
Good job.
Thank you. Are you okay?
مركز شنغهاي المالي العالمي ينتصب في برج طوله يناهز 490 مترا، وتستطيع أن تشاهد البرج أيضا من على سطح السفينة. هذه واحدة من المشاهدات وفق ثلاثة مستويات على ارتفاع 474 مترا. العنصر الأساسي في تصميم المبنى هو وجود فتحة في قمته، وقد بدأ العمل به عام 2003. وإذا أردت الاستماع بحياة راقية فيكفي أن تجلس في الطابق 92.
Remember, there's no way I'm going to let you experience Shanghai without stepping in one of the two of the highest bars in the world.
What does that mean? Do I have to look up?
What do you see?
There's like a boots and cabbage and hot water bottle, baby's pacifier, everyday objects.
Crazy, huh? Even though this is the Western bar, they've decorated it with modern Chinese art.
Well, the music sounds great, but what about the drinks?
Oh, don't worry about that. They have over 700 labels of wine from all over the world. That's the most in Shanghai.
It's going to take me more than half an hour just to get through that menu. Mm-hmm. And what about the other bar?
Oh, it's awesome, too. It's got a different style and over 50 different kinds of Chinese baijiu.
الحياة الليلية في بودونغ تختلف عن نادي فرانكي ميكس الذي يقع على الجهة الأخرى لنهر بوسي. نرى هنا بعض رجال الأعمال يحضرون من مختلف دول العالم يبحثون عن أماكن هادئة بعد يوم مضن من العمل الشاق. ليس هناك سوى طريقة واحدة للاسترخاء، نتمتع ببعض الموسيقى الجميلة. هناك أماكن مخصصة لرحلات العمل بالإضافة إلى البحث على الإنترنت.
Wow, what a difference a day makes. Look at it, it's bright and sunny, so I've chosen to come on my own. Now, usually it gets really rainy during springtime in Shanghai, but as you can see, we're in luck. Now, this Oriental Pole TV Tower is open from 8:30 a.m. in the morning till 9:30 p.m. at night, so you can get both day and night shots.
يقع المتحف التاريخي في برج لؤلؤة الشرق للتلفزيون، وهو يعرفك بمراحل تطور تاريخ النقل في مدينة شنغهاي. وبعد أن تدفع 35 يوانا تستطيع أن تتابع التقدم في المدينة من خلال معروضاتها. هذا هو المكان المناسب الذي يمكنك التعرف من خلاله على النهوض الذي شهدته مدينة بودونغ باعتبارها مدينة دولية. يمكنك أن تعرف أن منطقة بودونغ اجتذبت أكثر من 25 مليار دولار من الاستثمارات الأجنبية. في المتحف التاريخي ستجد مركزا مجهزا بأحدث الأجهزة السمعية والبصرية بمختلف اللغات، وهذا يعرفك أكثر بأهمية هذه المعروضات.
You know, at the end of the Qing Dynasty, Shanghai's guild began to imitate the Western style of goods exchange, and the earliest association formed by Chinese merchants was in 1920s. It was called the Shanghai Stock and Goods Exchange. There's a lot of hustle and bustle going on right now, and this job is definitely not for the faint-hearted. Sorry? Yeah, give me a five. Five.
لا يقتصر عمل الشركات العالمية العملاقة في مدينة بودونغ على المساعدة، وإنما للتأسيس أيضا وتسجيل الملاحظات الهامة. وفيما يتعلق بالتنمية، قد يكون لبودونغ الدور في ذلك، وإن الحصول على موطن قدم في الأسواق الصينية ليس أمرا صعبا.
I'm standing 259 meters above ground right now, and the view is just spectacular. You can see right across the Jingmao Tower and Shanghai World Financial Center. Now, the Oriental Pearl TV Tower was one of the first that was being built in the 90s, and it just epitomizes the height of success that Shanghai hopes to achieve. But if you look down, you might face your biggest nightmare. On top, and now we're going under. Now the Shanghai Ocean Aquarium is literally 2 minutes away, so we're going to check out some exciting sea life.
يتمتع أكواريوم شنغهاي بمميزات فريدة، حيث توجد فيه مجموعات كثيرة من الحيوانات المائية المهددة بالانقراض من نهر اليانغتسي. هناك نفق تحت الماء طوله 155 مترا، وتتمكن من خلال هذا النفق من مشاهدة كافة الحيوانات المائية. ويعد هذا النفق واحدا من أطول الأنفاق في العالم، حيث يعد المكان واحدا من الأماكن الشهيرة في شنغهاي. خصص أكواريوم شنغهاي سلسلة معارض لأسماك القرش تهدف إلى تشجيع الجمهور على عدم الإفراط في استهلاك زعانف القرش. وحظيت الحملة على دعم من لاعب كرة السلة يانغ مينغ بالإضافة إلى غيره من المشاهير من أجل حماية أسماك القرش. وهذا الحوض يعرف الأطفال بالحياة البحرية، فهو يعد عالما كبيرا ومتنوعا.
Shop, shop, shop till you drop, and that's exactly what I'm gonna do right here in this mall. Now there are shopping centers just like this all across Pudong, and there's only one message that's loud and clear: bask in all of consumerism's glory and buy.
بودونغ مكان عالمي جميل إلى جانب المراكز الدولية والعلامات التجارية المنتشرة في جميع أنحاء بودونغ تجد هناك انتشارا للمناظر الطبيعية وتلعب واجهات المحلات دورا هاما في إضفاء البهجة على هذه المدينة وبالنسبة للطعام ستجد مزيجا مذهلا من المطاعم الشرقية والغربية وحتى في أوج مواسم الازدهار
There's so much to see and do in Shanghai that you'd probably be out all day on your feet. And if you need a place to just rest your soul and calm your frazzled nerves, right here at Qi Spa.
Qi Spa في شانغريلا يقدم علاجا فريدا من نوعه حيث أن تقنياته مأخوذة من تقنيات العلاج الآسيوي وقد صمم ليناسب عناصر معينة من العناصر الخمسة وهي النار والماء والهواء والمعادن والتراب وهذا يعتبر مثالا رائعا على الطبيعة الدقيقة والمتأنية لشانغهاي
Well, they're preparing for me a special essential oil for my personality and element. It's metal, which is beauty and protection. I can't wait. Well, if you want to get away from the hectic pace of the city, this park is just for you. Now, it's hard to imagine that it's conveniently located right in the middle of Pudong. With this tranquil and peaceful setting, I'm going to just rest my weary soul.
نعود لعام 1990 عندما تم التخطيط للمدينة واتخذت القرارات بشأن الطريقة التي تجعل من المكان أنيقا وجميلا ما دفع الكثير من المهنيين إلى الانشغال ببناء المدينة لنرى المناطق الواسعة من الأحزمة الخضراء المرقة
This place is really peaceful and serene. The air is really crisp too, and I just walked from Century Park. It's just a short stroll, so if you're adventurous, you should do that. Now I'm meeting Stephen, and he's recommended a really good tea house. It's called Jiu Jian Tang.
تتميز قاعة الشاي جيو تيان تانغ في بودونغ بوجود تصاميم حديثة تشعرك بالحيوية والمتعة وفقا للفلسفة الصينية القديمة وتقاليد سلالة سونغ فإن طريقة تحضير الشاي يجب أن يكون فيها نوع من الفن ما يمنحك التأمل وتعتبر طريقة تحضير الشاي عند الصينيين شكلا من أشكال الغذاء الروحي هذا المقهى يقدم خدمات نلاحظ وجود الأكواب الأنيقة مع استخدام أجود أنواع الشاي
I really like it. I mean, being up on two great towers here in Shanghai was awesome, but being down on the ground, I think, is something I needed as well.
Oh, it's great, yeah, because there's a misconception in Shanghai that it's just a city of modernity and
fast.
Sure, it is. But there's also places like this that have a great deep connection with history. You can slow down, enjoy a cup of tea.
Wow. Age-old tradition, isn't it?
That's right, yeah.
Yeah, everyone knows Shanghai's old and new, modern, traditional, all of those things. And here, I like the tea. It is traditional tea served in a traditional way.
Right.
But with some modern elements, like these desserts that they make by hand.
Okay, I love desserts, but is there any connection to why we're actually having something
Absolutely.
With our tea?
There's always a connection. The Chinese culture isn't there.
Right.
And the meaning behind this is that most teas aren't meant to be drunk alone. They're meant to be enjoyed with something to eat.
Okay.
Because they could be too hard on the stomach. And so sometimes guazi seeds are served or little snacks, salty, sour. But here, they serve sweet snacks.
Very nice. That's perfectly logical.
لقد أوصانا ستيفن بأن نصعد الحافلة في الليل لنتعرف على عظمة منطقة بودونغ. هذه الحافلة من النوع المكشوف، تحتوي طابقين، وعند جلوسك في الطابق العلوي تتمتع بمشاهدة المنطقة. سيأخذنا الطريق إلى المناطق الهامة الموجودة في بودونغ، ويمكنك أن تستقل الحافلة من الصباح وحتى المساء، وبمساعدة أضواء الليل الجميلة يمكنك أن تلتقط الصور التذكارية.
This is the Shanghai City Guide.
Right.
It's on my phone. I get information about entertainment, events, restaurants, hotels, shopping, transportation, and travel.
لا يبعد مركز شنغهاي لفنون الشرق كثيرا عن لوجياتسوي، حيث تقدم في هذا المكان جميع المشاركات الدولية والمحلية للفنون المسرحية.
We're a little early for the performance, aren't we?
We are. Don't worry about that. I've got it covered.
You got it covered.
Yeah. Goodness.
All right.
Okay, so from the lobby, you never know that this little museum is up here.
Oh, it's incredible. This is a museum?
Yeah, it's one of Shanghai's best kept secrets.
What?
Hello, welcome to the Music Box Museum.
A Music Box Museum?
Yes, let me show you around.
All right.
معرض شنغهاي للمجموعات الموسيقية القديمة والأعمال الميكانيكية يأخذك إلى عالم الألحان الهادئة. ثقافة صندوق الموسيقى ترجع إلى القرن الرابع عشر، واليوم هي ثقافة واسعة لا حدود تقيدها.
And here we have a music box called Dix Music Box.
I did this. It's like a jukebox.
Yes, this is the first jukebox.
You're kidding me.
The first jukebox.
No. This is the first jukebox.
Cool.
So this is the grandfather of the technology.
Yes.
They look like saw blades, don't they?
Okay.
Like lumberjack
this
saw blades.
This look like...
It's got little bits of holes in it.
Yes.
How they figure this out?
A lot of little holes. And behind the disc, you can see a lot of hooks here. The little hooks touch the comb little behind.
But I'm not going to touch it because it probably costs a lot of money. As well. All right, so hands off.
Okay.
So this is... No.
This is the first CD player. If you want to listen it, you have to prepare a coin.
Wow, look at that.
الدمى في متحف العلب الموسيقية تقدم عروضا يومية، ومن الجميل أن يكون لدينا هذه الفرصة الفريدة لرؤية هذه الأعمال اليدوية القديمة والتي تعمل حتى الآن. هناك أنواع فاتنة من العلب الموسيقية تجسد مخيلة الأطفال والبالغين على حد سواء.
This is a really unique museum and an experience. I'm really glad you recommended this.
Yeah, I really like it because it's art and science, technology coming together. And so most art museums, you look at the paintings,
yeah,
and it's nice, but here you can interact with the antiques. It's cool. There's, what, 1796, the oldest music box here?
And you know, just because of that history, I think it revolutionized music industry as we know it. And most people don't even have a grasp of that knowledge until today, for me.
Yeah, and I think it's the best collection of music boxes in the world. And even though the ticket price is a little high, you can spend a couple hours here and the guides will show you each of the boxes.
It's worth it.
Yeah.
مركز بودونغ للفن الشرقي بشنغهاي يرحب بأعمال الكثير من العاملين في مجالات الموسيقى والدراما وفنون الأداء، في حين أن بودونغ معروفة في إنجازاتها المالية، ومركز رعاية الفن هو تقدير للفنون التشكيلية من خلال تقديم أعمال ذات مستوى عالمي للسكان المحليين.
A toast to a great choice, Steve. I mean, I feel like it could be anywhere in the world right now because it's so modern and international, but that is the iconic Huangpu River just running across it.
That's right.
here at this restaurant, you get a great view of the skyline, and I wanted to show you just how international Shanghai can be.
Yeah.
You know, in this city, you can find any taste you want, from French, Italian, Indian, Japanese, and even in Shanghai people's homes, they know how to cook international food. They have for years. And you can hear them speaking English from old to young.
Yeah, but that's sort of Shanghainese people being very open to foreign culture.
Sure.
But what about foreigners who come into Shanghai? Do they make the effort as well?
Funny you should ask, because many foreigners in Shanghai speak the local language, Shanghai Hua.
Really? Prove it.
Bataka means mei wen ti, no problem.
Bataka.
Yeah, bataka.
Oh, that's sweet.
Yeah.
Bataka.
Another easy one is Xiaoyanong.
Xiaoyanong.
Yeah, Xiaoyanong.
What's that?
Thank you.
Xiaoyanong. Oh.
Tomato tartar ham, ham and ice cream.
Thank you.
That's something good. Soup, your langoustines, served with potato fondant.
Thank you.
Good.
It looks delicious.
Xiaoyanong.
مطاعم شنغهاي أنيقة وفاخرة، وبعد التعرف على الطعام المحلي والدولي لابد وأن تأتي إلى هنا، لأنك في شنغهاي على استعداد لتناول الكثير من الأطباق الفاخرة. بودونغ هي نقطة انطلاق اقتصاد شنغهاي، وتعد هذه المنطقة النافذة على الشرق بالنسبة للشركات الأجنبية. صنع في شنغهاي تسمية رائجة في كل الصين، يمكنك زرع الثقة في منتجات شنغهاي.
Pudong is a newly minted area in the 90s, and it's very modern, new, international. But if you have a thirst for old Shanghai, well, you can get across the Huangpu River and get on the ferry, and you can grab a cab or a bus, but this only takes 5 minutes, and it's a fraction of the time. And the best part about this, it only costs this much. 谢谢.